principal, sir, my colleagues and students. Am I audible? Okay, is it clear? Voice is clear,
yes,
Vijay?
Yes, yes.
On behalf of CIM, I welcome you all to our new student orientation program. It really gives me the greatest pleasure to welcome our freshmen to the college family. I hope you are as excited as I have been to enter a campus with unlimited possibilities. The main goal of our university education is to facilitate the intellectual maturation and development of students. Albert Einstein once said, "The value of an education in college is not the learning of many facts, but the training of the mind to think something that cannot be learned from textbook." The vision of our college is to emerge as a premier engineering and management institute of the country with academic excellence in collaboration with industry and develop students as modern citizens who would serve and enrich the society by using their technical prowess competently. I hope this is something you will appreciate and put into practice as you pursue knowledge. We emphasize the importance of collegial community because we want to make sure that students' learning process is one of guidance and support. Our small class size ensures that students can make the most out of their study by working closely with a group of dedicated, learned, and approachable faculty. Your professor's door is open whenever you need to discuss an academic subject, a career choice, or anything related to academics, because the goal of our collegial community is your complete cultivation and all-around development. I hope you will learn the ability to understand and share the feelings with one another. Today, we live in a world where conflicts and violence between nations, races, religions, political parties, and individuals are a daily fare. We need a generation of young people who have genuine care and respect for nature and humanity, as well as a broad understanding of the world. Indeed, to care for others, to be responsible for their own action, to serve the local community and beyond, and to make a positive impact for the betterment of humanity is our core value. Our multicultural campus provides an excellent environment for us to understand the idea of common good, diversity and respect. In the coming 4 years, you meet, interact with classmates whose characters and habits are entirely different from yours. You may also work with someone who has opposite views on your joint project. No matter what the situation, I hope you will always have an empathy and respect for each other. Going to college is not only about getting a well-paid job. It is a place for you to explore and transform. How much you received at the end of the journey depends on how much effort you have put in. As you begin your study, I urge you to develop winning attitude right from today. Set goal for yourself, study hard, learn as much as possible, make good use of various opportunities available here, and always remember passion, loyalty, perseverance, openness to different ideas and cultures, and a readiness to serve. I trust that the vigorous and personal education here will help you grow and achieve your potential. I hope you will enjoy the orientation program, and I look forward to seeing you all on campus. Now I will request Principal Sir to say something to our student. Principal, sir.
Okay, I'm audible and visible. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good morning. Good morning to my dear first year students. Good morning to all the faculty members who are present here. Now it is my great pleasure to welcome you, the newly admitted first year students. I welcome you to our homely, caring atmosphere of CIM. Now, I should say that CIM always puts the student at the center of everything it does, always. And I assure you a great experience here. Your success is important to each and every member of CIM family. What's here? Here, the teachers are very helpful and kind. You should always keep in touch with your teachers. They are your guardians here. All the first year students presently are under the Department of Basic Science and Humanities. Now, your departmental head is Madam Professor Dr. Suparna Sengupta. You will be under the guidance and supervision of Madam. After 1 year, that is from third semester, you will be under your respective branch department. Now, soon you will be introduced by Suparna Madam, your departmental head, of course, first year departmental head, and the respective departmental heads. Now, I also again assure you that we shall leave no stone unturned to you with best possible training and exposure so that you can shape your career and growth for a challenging life. Now, I am sure that you will find proud on being associated with us and make us equally proud with your academic excellence. Now, I should say that I want to encourage you to work very hard and get focused from the onset. I also urge you to take your studies very seriously and work hard. Now, well, nothing more I want to say at this moment. Be and remain a good human being. Be healthy and be alert to keep your health good. Now, you should remember that as a student, a healthy mind resides in a healthy body. I wish you every success at CIM, and I'm confident that you will find it immensely rewarding experience. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for your valuable speech. Now, I will request Shonali Shorkel, the HOD of EC department, to say a few words to our student. Okay, Shonali.
Thank you, Sharma Madam.
Hello.
Yes, am I audible? Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you, Shamadi. Okay. So, good morning, everyone, and a warm welcome to all the students. Welcome to CIEM family. Before going ahead, I would like to introduce myself. I am Shonali Shorkel, teacher in charge of ECE department. So, all the students of ECE, a warm welcome to ECE family. ECE, Electronics and Communication Engineering, it's a dynamic and exciting area that provides excellent career opportunities in various areas of technology. Now come to the department. Our department faculties are very committed to teach our students the fundamental concepts as well as the latest trends. Okay. We have well-equipped lab, a good teacher-student ratio. More specifically, we have 7 well-equipped lab and we always maintain 16:1 student-teacher ratio. Now, the students can include themselves in various club activities like coding, innovation, sports, etc. Okay. We have a very rich innovation cell where you can explore your thoughts. One-to-one mentoring facilities are also available. We provide one-to-one mentoring facilities in our department, college also. Okay. So you can consider your mentor as your friend. Means you can share all your thoughts other than academics. Okay, you can consider him or her as your friend. So we provide that facility also. We have well-organized centralized library as well as departmental library. Centralized library, you can avail the facility of learning international journals, where you can access various international journals. Okay. Other than classroom teaching, students can also avail the facilities of remedial classes. So lots of opportunities are there. Come to the department, avail those facilities, explore various things, and that's all. Okay. So come to the department. Once again, welcome to the world and all the best for next 4 years. That's all. Thank you. Thank you all. Okay. Thank you, Shravati. That's all.
Okay. Thank you, Sonali. Is there any student from EC department? Hello? If you have any question, you can ask.
Yes.
Yes. Right? Is there any student from...
All the students of ECE have joined the program. So if you want to ask anything, you can ask me. You can ask me later, okay? As you have already familiar with my phone number, you can ask me now also.
Actually, the thing is, if we don't interact with your student, then our program will be not complete, right? Please ask any question if you have. Do you have anything in your mind? Whatever, fearlessly just ask us. Okay, we are here to answer your question. Our main motto is you should be satisfied, right? This is the first year. Make us as a friend, and whatever things you have in your mind, just come and tell us, right?
Good morning,
teacher.
So
there is no question. Yeah, welcome.
Thank you so much.
Srishti Das.
Yes, this is Srishti Das. I just want to ask our respected Sonali ma'am that when I was first admitted to CIEM, I was admitted to EC.
Yes.
So, and according to the trend followed by the parents here, always they choose CS for their words. So I had to convince my mother that I can do well in ECE also and also get all the opportunities as the CS students will get. So yes. How far do you think, ma'am, that
Yes, of course. For CSC and IT students, they will get the opportunity to explore in software field. Okay. But for ECE students, they will get the opportunity for both hardware and software. Okay. So, yes, you have chosen the right stream. Okay. And after 4 years, you will get to know that whether you have chosen right or wrong. Okay. Yes, Srishti.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Any other questions? Yesterday, one of the students of EC department have asked me that when we will get the timetable. When they will get the timetable. So
it's today, good morning all. So today evening I will upload all the first year routine to their respective streams. So every student will get it here. From tomorrow at 10 AM, regular classes will be started, and in the any vacant slot you will get the link for the induction program. That program is already uploaded in the so student can see at what time they have an induction program talk, and from 10 AM onwards till 5:30 routine is arranged. So today evening they will get the routine, first routine.
Okay, thank you, Shupanda Madam.
So is there any question from any of EC departmental student? Okay. So now I am the TIC of Civil Engineering Department. Before starting, I want to say something about Civil Engineering Department. Okay, is there any student from Civil Engineering Department? I know Simran is there. Is there any other student?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, who is this? Siddhant. Okay.
Yes,
so I know the number of students in civil department is less because of the current situation, but I will promise you in the later you will find this type of the core departments, that is civil, electrical, mechanical, okay? The prospect is not so less, okay? You will find later on. So now I want to tell something about civil engineering, right? Civil engineering remains one of the oldest discipline. It is a major sector as it deals with design, construction, maintenance of physical structure. Civil engineers ensure that all public techniques and systems are up to standard. Some utilities that engineers have managed to build, including the municipal building, whatever you are seeing around your, okay, all those are municipal building, water switch works, bridge, dam, airport, filtration structure, and the design of city street system, etc. Civil engineering is an umbrella covering many other fields. These are the specialization under it, such as transportation engineering, structural engineering, environmental engineering, coastal engineering, material engineering, surveying, and geotechnical engineering. These are the branches. Lots of branches are there. Now, all new streams are coming under civil engineering. Those are considered as separate thing. Okay, so you will get bachelor on that. That is construction practice like this way. The areas covered by civil engineering are very crucial. Why? Any mistake done in the process of designing or construction can cause grave disaster to public. Those who decided to focus on civil engineering must have the know-how on the given field under analysis. A thorough training is required. The maintenance of high standards of engineering ethics ensures continuous and ever-improving standard of society's infrastructure. So this is very important for civil engineers, right? I know people are not liking as because you have to work hard in this field. And exposure nowadays, actually software is everywhere. So nobody will willing to take those core subjects. But believe me, ultimately you need, okay. The civil engineering has always played a pivotal role in the world civilization. This is caused by the increase in literacy practice within this profession. A person who decide to undertake this line must really devote oneself to getting more information as a way of improving oneself and this sector. A civil engineer should be able to design and accurately represent authentic structure. This should represent an actual situation on the ground. Within the civil engineering community, getting higher education is enabled through online degrees given by recognized and accredited universities. One is able to continue with the present commitment, conveniently obtaining a master's degree. So doing job, you can increase your qualification. Accordingly, you can approach yourself in the society. Okay. The civil engineering community represents an important sector of economy too. It is a sector requires a constant improvement to keep up with the ever-changing world. Without all players in this sector committing themselves to improvement, there would be no development. Therefore, this community is a professional body changed with a responsibility of ensuring that structure are up to date with the latest technology. So see, whatever we are constructing, it is changing. So you need the literacy practice in this stream. Okay, and thus all interested responsibilities must take it upon to them, embrace literacy practice within this sector. This is a sure way of ensuring the continual improvement and growth of this crucial sector. So civil engineering is an interesting profession. This is a profession with the task of ensuring solving of architectural problem. You know, there are few civil engineer students. You will always we have always a conflict with architecture. Architecture prepare an imaginary thing and we have to actually construct it, right? So life could have been difficult without the input of this discipline. Now, there are few things also you have to remember. See, whatever see around us, transport system has been improved through this construction of, through the construction of highways. Traffic has also been controlled through this well-connected roads. Building a bridge across river and lakes has helped to avoid unnecessary death that occur while people trying to cross rivers using boat. Life expectancy has greatly been improved because of the construction of efficient water treatment plant. Disease have been kept at minimum rate as population are able to get clean water to their doorstep. On the other hand, a design and construction of sewage system have solved hygiene problems caused by contaminated waste. The improvement of general living standard of people can never be overemphasized. The importance of these advances is so great that any mistake in the process of their implementation may lead to disaster that could affect the whole economy. In this case, a responsibility lies squared on the head of civil engineering. Therefore, this is a fulfilling profession for those who like taking responsibilities. Among with a desire to be responsible for all he or she does fits for this profession. So your aim should be that you should help the nature and community. You have to work hard. If you think I will sit in the AC room and I will get a well-paid job, for those students, this is not the profession. You have to work hard. You have to construct. You have to prepare a thing. People will see it and say, oh, what a wonderful structure. What a wonderful project he have done, he or she have done. So whatever we go through in the dream, we can actually construct it physically. And people will see it. And the things will be three-dimensional, that you can see it, you can touch it, you can satisfy, okay, I am doing that. For this, definitely, you should work hard. The conception and the basic theory should be clear to you, okay? A formal school instructional application is necessary, definitely, if one wants to pursue this career. A good background in mathematics, algebra, geometry, physics, English, and also social studies is very important for succeeding in this field. It is a rewarding career since it is well paid. The time spent for training is never in vain. You will think that, okay, I'm doing this training free of cost. Okay, and you will feel, oh, I am not getting well paid, so I will. No, all the trainings will give you experience, what you can use in your field when you are doing a job or getting a job. You will crack the interview if you have a good knowledge, right? So one is able to input all skills in meaningful projects that serve the society and to learn a good life living at the same time. This only become possible through progressive learning in the field. So this field is always improving and you have to follow the current trend. Moreover, civil engineering is a field that is never affected by economic recession, whereas many sectors were affected by economic recession. This sector creates more opportunities. These opportunities are always available for anyone who is able to do this, do his or her best. The more you learn, the more opportunities avail themselves in this field. This is why online training provides a good opportunity. So you have to improve, update yourself, whatever online system is coming, right? Because all the people wants to avoid hard working. So nowadays coming where you can do much of things through online, right? So that's why you have to up to date with computer system, whatever package is coming, right? So this is why online training provides us a good opportunity for any ambitious civil engineers who are ready to venture into new engineering territories. Talents are constantly required in this field. But I don't know why people don't want to take this as profession. Maybe they do not want to work hard. That may be a reason. So whatever, this is the total picture of civil engineering discipline. Now come to our college. Let us take a look at what our college has to offer you. We have several laboratories in accordance to your syllabus. We have solid mechanics laboratory, transportation lab, concrete lab, environment lab, civil surveying instrument, soil geotechnical lab. So in this lab, you can do, yes, whatever instrument we have that generally supports our syllabus, but you can do whatever you like, because those are the basic thing, and through those instruments, you can do lots of experiments too, but you have to devote your time. We also have an AutoCAD lab where we conduct few additional courses beyond the syllabus to make you industry ready, right? You know, industry now wants a student who is updated. He or she should know all the online packages, all the things, so that they do not train them. They do not use their salary for training. So that's why we try to conduct few online courses, which is not in our syllabus, to up to date you yourself, right? We try to provide you with an outlook of how the construction industry operates by arranging a few industrial construction site visit. Okay, if you go to industrial site, you will have an idea that, okay, the thing is done like this. Actually, you know, there is a big difference between the theoretical knowledge and the practical one, right? We want that you should be compatible. That is, you should know the theoretical as well as the practical. So that's why we will try to arrange few industrial visits through which you can have the knowledge of practical world. Now, you know, our syllabus is in MacOut. Okay, so if you go through it, our whole courses are divided into 8 sems. Okay, there are 8 semesters, and few things you will learn in 3rd or 4th or like this. But all the things are important. In a particular semester, you will have theoretical paper, practical, and also sessional, right? Practical, there you have to give 4 internal examinations, okay, CA1 to CA4. And then in case of practical, there are 2, as because now it is online, you have to give those exams in online base also. And in practical, you have to perform 2 internal, that is PC1 and PC2. Then you have to appear in the examination. Right? Like this way, the things are divided. So my request to you, devote yourself, work hard, and whatever I have told you in the in the first speech, that you have to, whatever you will get, whatever you put in, don't expect I will put in less and I will have great effect. Okay, so be serious, work hard, then success is always there, but you have to work hard. And also, this is a college life, you have to enjoy certain things. Sonali ma'am already told us, whatever we have central library, departmental library. There are so many things, cultural group, drama group, and each year is compact with all these things. There are lots of extracurricular activities you can carry on. So all depends upon you, how we will perform, how you will do. Okay, so that is all about my department. Another thing, in the last year, that is in the fourth year, you have to do a project. Okay, that project should be important, and you have to, that is a later thing. Later we will discuss that. So that is also an important thing which will help you later in your career. So this is all about from my department. Now I want to ask you, is any question do you have? You can ask me. Any question? Another thing to my department, language is not the issue. If you are shy about telling anything in English, you can ask me in Hindi also. Okay, but I want that, don't be shy. Whatever in your mind, just pick it up. We are here to help you. Okay, we will improve your English, everything. But the thing is, don't shy. Don't make yourself hide from us. Then it will be difficult for us to trace your character, to keep you up, right? So that's why take us as a friend, as a mentor, and whatever you have, whatever any kind of problem, just let us know it. We will there to help you. See, our success is seeing your success. If you're successful, we are satisfied. We are not here to getting the pay package, right? We are there to help you. Someday you will say, okay, I am a student of this ma'am. That is the appreciation for us. So like this, I want to say best of luck to you all. And thank you choosing CIM and come here. We are here to help you. Right. So now I want to hand over. Is there any question from a civil engineering student? Whatever question you can ask me. So no, there is no question. So now I will hand over the mantle to the Sumanto Dash, HOD Electrical Department, for further proceeding. Sumantoda, welcome.
Thank you, ma'am. Very good morning. Thank you very much. Very good morning to my dear students. Welcome to 2021 to 2022 academic session. Now, our every members of CIM are ready to include all our first semester students in our CIM family. Now, just as a teacher in charge of electrical engineering department and all the departmental community, and behalf of all my departmental community, I am here to support you every step in your academic journey and career. Now, one thing I'm telling you very clearly, there's nothing should stop you from achieving success in any way. There should be each and every student of your first year, or each and every student, they should have a mission, they should have their vision. And obviously, we are here to just absolutely all the members of the Electrical Engineering Department, all the members of CIM are here to just help you to achieve your goal. Now, so we have to take the advantage of each and every opportunity that CIM has. So the CIM means, I'm telling all the departments, that is the electrical department, about the facility we are having, we have to explore those facilities. Number, that is another thing I should say in this way. This is having a lot of resources, and we should know how to explore those resources for the benefit of the students. And obviously, the students, they should come in front to explore it. And we are ready, and we are absolutely ready to share all the resources what CIIM has. Now, keeping in mind the COVID-19, obviously the situation is slightly different. That is, it is absolutely different from other years. And obviously, this COVID-19 situation, we are observing it very closely. And obviously, we have updated our policies, that is, and procedures of teaching and learning. And my dear students, we will, first of all, we will deliver our lectures, we will deliver our laboratories to online, and we are thinking about it. If the situation changes, we will also go for offline situation. You don't have to worry about it. But one thing I should say, in this session, that is importance of electrical engineering. This is a core engineering, and I am telling you very clearly, the industry needs fresh engineers, the industry needs core engineers, and the industry needs the electrical engineers, civil engineers, and so on. But the electrical, there is a huge shortage of electrical engineers in the core industry. But one thing you have to keep in mind, the industry is not ready to take the freshers to include in their family. Because why? Because they are telling that these students are not ready, these students are not fit for the industry. So why? What then we have to think in another way. That is, each and every students, each and every faculty members, we have to think in other ways. Why that deficit is there? Because the students, they are not paying that attention for the core industry. That is, they are not paying attention to these core subjects. Now, the core subjects needs a very clear-cut knowledge. Core subjects needs a very, that is, electrical engineering also needs a very clear-cut knowledge. The basic knowledge should be absolutely clear. And to make it clear, you have to study the basic things, that is the chemistry, that is the physics, mathematics, mechanics, that is the basic electrical engineering. And all these subjects are the basic boundary. That is, they actually build the function of electrical engineering. And I will request all my dear students to just utilize each and every moment, each and every of this particular time, because you will be staying at home, and obviously you are getting a lot of time, and try to utilize that particular time just in your study. Now, one thing I'm telling you, that is, let us tell about the CIIM. The CIIM Kolkata, that is Prashantoshu campus, it was established in the year 2003. And the department and our academic, it was started from that very day. Now, from the same time, electrical has started. And now, Department of Electrical Engineering is actively engaged in teaching and research with modern laboratories and excellent faculty members. Now, our department has there are 10 laboratories. There is a basic electrical engineering laboratory, circuit theory and simulation laboratory, instrumentation laboratory, system laboratory, electrical machine laboratory, advanced electrical machine laboratory, because the electrical machine laboratory, there are two electrical machine laboratories are there. The power system laboratory, there also exists two power system laboratories, electronics laboratories, electric drives laboratories, and electrical design laboratories. There are a lot of laboratories are there. I request each and every student to go through those laboratories. They are very, very beautiful, and beautiful laboratories are there. The big labs are waiting for you. Now, the CIM also is having an innovation cell, and also the electrical engineering departmental students, they actively take part in that particular innovation cell. And that innovation cell always encourage and inspire our students to work with new ideas. And obviously, the students, they execute their new idea with different type of models, different type of projects. And a lot of students, they have achieved a lot of things from that particular innovation cell. Now, we organize, that is, periodic workshops and seminars, interactive sessions with different training programs. That is collaborations with we are also in collaboration with the industry. We generally that is we organize different internship sessions with the entrepreneurs. So we that is these are the regular these are the regular activities of. Now we always keep close contact with the students, because through our mentoring, there is a one-to-one mentoring is there. We are on the particular process of mentoring. And I if they have any problem, but any misconception, or any other problems, whatever it may be, they come to our department. They can directly contact with the mentors to resolve it. Now, obviously, that is all the faculty members are the part of our this mentorship programs. We are having delegate faculties, serious faculties, and obviously they are always ready to help our students. Now, with this, CIM is also having a counselor. The counselor also takes an active role for counseling the students. And I should say that every student, they should keep a close contact with their mentors, with their department. Now, I also expect my students of the electrical engineering department, they should also be free. They should feel free to make contact with their mentors, to make contact with the HOD or teacher in charge, whatever it may be. So, so that is the basic thing. There should not exist a gap between a teacher and student. Because if you want to deliver, if I want to teach you, and if I want to clear your concept, so it should be an interactive session. So interactive session means, so that is the sessions to which a student can clear his or her idea with the help of the faculty members. So this is an important thing. Now, electrical engineering is basically a core subject, and without electricity, nothing can happen in this modern world. So if you just, so the core sector always, these core sectors, they will have their own importance throughout the civilization. Without core, the civilization can't exist. So under that particular situation, I should say in this way, the civil engineering, the mechanical engineering, and the electrical engineering, the core engineering courses, and you can't think without this particular course. So electrical engineering, first comes the civil, then comes the electrical engineering, and obviously you can't say that these courses are invalid courses, or these courses is not so important, because industry needs freshers, industry needs a lot of pressures to recruit in their sector, but they are not getting. They are just in short of engineers. I'm telling you very frankly. Lot of students are in industry. They are just telling in this way. So we need serious students. We need a student who is having a basic concept. Now, just let me tell you just one particular thing, but just as an example. Now, in an interview, just in a basic interview, that is a question was asked, just showing a particular model on the best plate something is written, and what is the meaning of those particular statements which is written on the best plate. Now, these are the basic things. What type of motor it is, what is its dimension, where we are going to. So these are the basic things, the basic concept, what type of supply is required, what is its output, what is its efficiency. So when you are in the laboratory or when you are in the class, try to study in detail. Try to put question in front of your teacher. So what is its meaning? So what do you mean by this? So there should be a minimum gap between a teacher and a student. Then and then only we will be able to give our best to our students. Now, again, I'm telling you, don't, we are in a pandemic situation, and obviously we have to think in a different way. We have to think this teaching learning process in a different dimension. And as Tomusha Madam has told us just now, that is, we have to think in a slightly in a different way. Yes, ma'am, I agree with you. And each and every student have to think in a different way. So thanks a lot. I wish very good health to all my faculty members, to all my students also. Let us start our academic journey. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Shumando, the vote of thanks. Okay.
Hey, for your permission, I will do.
Okay, go, proceed.
So, it is my great pleasure to present vote of thanks on behalf of CIEN to all the to all my colleagues, and I just feel privileged to be present in front of you. So, on behalf of CIEN, I extend my sincere thanks to our principal, sir, Professor S. Hill, who has shared his busiest schedule. I thank her. From your lectures, we got the opportunity to hear your idea, thought, and suggestion. Your detailed explanation about the CIEN and the teaching learning process, how we are going to continue, obviously it will encourage us. It will encourage our students for their future. Now, I should show my gratitude to our speaker, Tonushyama Madam, who have beautifully explained the importance of this particular orientation program, the teaching learning process, and the way she introduced the first year students to CIE. Now, this has raised this. Immensely thankful to Professor Sonali Madam for her effort towards this session, and obviously she has shared her idea and explanation Now, I need to mention my deepest appreciation for this session of and sort of for everyone's involvement and willingness for the success of this particular program. I pray God for good help to each and every member of CIM, to each and every student of CIM. Thank you, sir. Thank you for this particular program. Thank you.
Okay, Shubhana ma'am, so we are is there any question from any actually vote of thanks given? So this is the end of the session. Okay, Shubhana di, so we may end the program here with your due permission, right? So thank you, student, for attending this first phase of orientation program. We will again come tomorrow and day after like this. The session will go on up to the 9th. Okay, Shubhana di, is it so? You are mute. Please unmute yourself, ma'am.
Okay. This induction program will continue up to October 8th before Puja vacation. And after that, from 25th, again the program will be given to the group and it will continue for at least 21 days. We will inform you accordingly, all the students.
Okay, so we are ending the program here. Okay, thank you very much, all of you who are present here. Okay, thank you, Shumantoda. Thank you, everybody. Shonali, Shumantoda, Obhijit, and also ma'am, principal, sir, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Obhijit for conducting the program. Thank you all. Now we can end.